Hey guys, welcome back. So, if you've ever tried to build a keyboard before, chances are your stabilizers may have sounded like this. This is known as stabilizer rattle, and it can be extremely annoying to get rid of. Sometimes, no matter how much lube you put in, or how balanced your wires are, or how many tutorials you end up following, your stabilizers will still have this annoying rattle and ticking noise every time you press on it. I've experienced this firsthand, and I've sometimes spent literal hours or days just working on stabilizers, so trust me when I say that I can totally relate. So today, we're gonna be taking a look at the Holy mod. If you're not familiar, it's an extremely effective DIY mod for your stabilizers that almost always removes all rattle while maintaining a very smooth sound and feel if done right. I use the Holy mod for all of my stabilizers and keyboards, and it has saved me hours of pain. It's just really, really good. All right, so before we get started, you're going to need these items: Krytox 205G0, two brushes, a tweezer, a plastic cutter, sharp scissors, and most importantly, fabric band-aids. They need to have a bit of thickness, but not be too thick so that it blocks the entire stabilizer stem, and try to avoid getting the plastic band-aids that are waterproof, as they are too thin and provide no actual cushioning for the Holy mod. There are two types of stabilizers. We have plate-mounted stabilizers and PCB-mounted stabilizers. The Holy mod is not exclusive to either type of stabilizer, so you can follow along regardless of which one you have. My personal favorite stabilizers are Zeal PC and Duroc V2 Stabs. They are the most consistent and smooth stabilizers I've ever used, so I highly recommend them. I'll put the links down to them in the description below. Your stabilizers will have three main components. You have the stabilizer wires, the stabilizer housings, and the stabilizer stems. The first thing you want to do is make sure that all of these components are dry. If the stabilizers come pre-lubed, you definitely want to remove any factory lube before continuing. The method I personally use requires hand soap, a bowl, an old toothbrush, and a clean, dry brush. I like to dunk my stabilizer stems and housings into the bowl, wash it with soap, and use a toothbrush to clean the insides. Then I use some water to flush out any excess, and that usually works really well for me. If it's really bad, I like to get a clean dry brush to just push out any excess lube, and to dry them, you can either leave them to air dry or shake them inside some tissue. So next up, depending on the stabilizer, you may have to clip them. Unclipped stabilizer stems will look like this. They have these two extra legs on the bottom, which will make the stabilizers feel a little mushy, which is not what you want. So get your plastic clippers or scissors and cut off the two extra legs. You want to make sure that you cut off the entire leg so that the bottom of the stabilizer is completely flat. Try to avoid having any uneven plastic on the bottom of your stabilizers for a cleaner sound and feel. So once your stabilizers are dry and are clipped, we can now move on to the Holy mod. The main objective of the Holy mod is to place a band-aid into the stabilizer stem to cushion the stabilizer wire and reduce rattle. So to get started, get your fabric band-aid and peel off one side. That way you can still hold on to the other end without it sticking to your hands. You then want to cut off a small piece of band-aid that is roughly the size of the whole of the stabilizer stem. Try to avoid cutting a piece that's too big, as it'll make the stabilizer feel mushy and heavy. And try to avoid cutting a piece that's too small, as it can reduce the overall effectiveness of the Holy mod. So once you've cut the band-aid to an appropriate size, stick the band-aid onto your tweezer and slide it into the stabilizer stem like this. You want to slide your tweezer in through the side where there is one angled hole and not the end with two holes. After that, you want to use your fingers to gently pull off the band-aid from the tweezer and press down the end of the band-aid on the side where there is one angled hole. Try your best to make sure that the band-aid is secure and does not stick out the side of the stem. If it sticks on the wall slightly, it's okay. Just make sure that your band-aid covers the entire ramp, as I like to call it. I like to use my tweezers to apply some force to make sure that it sticks onto the stem. And once it's secure, you can now move on to the other side. You want to cut off some of the band-aid, but leave a small amount so that you can push the rest into the shorter hole below. This is to make sure that the band-aid stays in place and doesn't move even though the wire rubs against it. So push the band-aid into the short hole using a tweezer and press down so that it sticks. And just to make sure, use your tweezer to press around the stabilizer stem until everything feels firm. And once that's done, you just have to repeat that for the rest of your stabilizer stems. If you're doing this for the first time, it can be a little frustrating and a bit time consuming, but once you get into the rhythm of things and you practice a little bit more, it's actually really easy. All right, so with the main part of the Holy mod complete, we can now move on to lubing our stabilizers. For lube, I like to use Krytox 205G0 as it provides a very smooth sound and feel without feeling too thick or too thin. So I like to start off by lubing my stabilizer housings. I get a pretty decent amount of lube on my brush and apply it on all sides of the housing. After that, I apply a fairly thin layer of lube onto the stabilizer stems until the two faces are evenly coated. After that, I put the stabilizer stem and housing back together. If you have trouble knowing which way to put it back in, the side of the stem with two holes should line up with the entrance of the stabilizer housing. It is always a really good practice to make sure that the stabilizer stem and housing line up, because if they don't, the stabilizer will straight up not work and you're gonna have to take it apart and flip the stem around. It's just a huge waste of time and you should just always double check. All right, so next up we have the stabilizer wires. I like to apply a generous amount of lube onto the wires until you can just see the wire underneath the lube. You wanna try your best to get it as even as possible, and also make sure that you lube the area where the wire clips onto the stabilizer housing. You then want to insert the lubed part of the wire into the stabilizer housing, and this can be a little bit annoying as the fabric band-aid will block the entrance slightly. Try your best not to force the wire in and gently rotate and push it in until the wire slides in easily. Once the wire enters the stabilizer stem, push down until it clicks into place. You should hear an audible click once it goes in, and then repeat this for the other side of the wire. Unfortunately, there is no exact amount of lube to use with each stabilizer. It really is just sort of a trial and error thing, and it comes with experience. As you continue to lube and mod more stabilizers, you'll get a better feel for how much lube you should be using and how much you shouldn't be using, and it just comes with practice. Alright, so once you've reassembled all of your stabilizers, we can now begin testing them. Mount your stabilizers into your PCB or plate and start pressing gently on each side. Try to apply very minimal amounts of force, and you're just tapping it gently. The only sounds you should be able to hear are the sounds of the keycap moving or a very light tapping noise. After that, try to press the switches down like you normally would and go side to side and press down on the edges of the keycap. This should give you a good idea of how they will sound and feel when you're actually using it. If you can still hear a bit of rattle, the first thing I want you to try and do is putting some lube into the back of your stabilizer. If that doesn't fix it, then it's usually to do with the band-aid or the wire itself. I recommend double checking that your band-aid covers the entire surface of the stem and is not sticking out on either side. I also recommend learning more about wire balancing, and I'll link some guides down in the description below. Keep in mind that you will feel a bit of resistance from the holding mod, and it is completely normal, as long as it doesn't make it really hard to press down or if it feels like there's a bump like a tactile switch. It should just feel slightly more resistant. With the holding mod, it's actually really important that you break them in to make them feel a lot smoother. It doesn't take a long time either. I recommend just wearing them down through everyday use or just by spamming the stabilizers for a good like 5 to 10 minutes. But the more you use your stabilizers, the smoother they will sound and feel. Modding your stabilizers is, in my opinion, the most important mod you can do with any of your keyboards. The quality of your keyboard is directly related to the quality of your stabilizers. No matter how expensive your case is or how good your switches are or how beautiful your keycaps are, if your stabilizers are bad, the quality of your keyboard goes down by a lot. So I highly recommend that you spend a lot of time making sure that your stabilizers sound and feel as good as you possibly can, and I hope that the Holy Mod could help make that process a lot easier. If you guys have any more questions, feel free to comment down below or join my Discord server, discord.gg/homogeneo, and follow me on Twitter and Instagram @homogeneo. You can also join my channel to become a member so you get badges, cool perks, as well as exclusive channels on my Discord server if you link your YouTube account to your Discord account. I know, it's a lot. So as always, thank you for watching and happy lubing.